it is a big world out there, but we are easy to locate. We are Lamb of God Lutheran Church, located at 2791 Inca Drive and the junction of Inca Way in Lake Havasu City, Arizona. Lamb of God is a member of the Lutheran Church Missouri Synod, Southwest District. Welcome to Lamb of God Lutheran Church on this glorious Easter morning. Our sermon is titled, All Things Possible, Dream Big, and is presented by Pastor Skip Nazinski. Welcome to our worship service.
Hallelujah, Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed. Hallelujah.
Please stand now and face the back of the sanctuary. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. We gather in the presence of God to celebrate the most significant event in the history of the whole world, the fulfillment of God's own promise to mankind from the beginning, the undoing of the curse of death, and the defeat of the cause of death, namely sin. It is the resurrection of the Lord Jesus Christ from death. He did not die for himself. He died the death of Adam and Eve and all of their descendants. He died for your death and mine. After 3 days in a cold tomb of death, he arose bodily and to this day lives and rules the universe. The fact of his resurrection is a celebration of faith. This victory is assured to all who believe. Though we still sin and though we die, by faith in Jesus, the living Lord, sin is forgiven and taken away, and death becomes but the gate to our own resurrection to eternal life. Listen now to this good news. The Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew, the 28th chapter.
Glory to you, Lord.
Now after the Sabbath, toward the dawn of the first day of the week, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went to see the tomb. And behold, there was a great earthquake, for an angel of the Lord descended from heaven and came and rolled back the stone and sat on it. His appearance was like lightning, and his clothing white as snow. And for fear of him, the guards trembled and became like dead men. But the angel said to the women, "Do not be afraid, for I know that you seek Jesus who was crucified. He is not here, for he is risen, as he said. Come see the place where he lay. Then go quickly and tell the disciples that he is risen from the dead, and behold, he is going before you to Galilee. There you will see him. See, I have told you." So they departed quickly from the tomb with fear and great joy, and ran to tell his disciples. And behold, Jesus met them and said, "Greetings." And they came up and took hold of his feet and worshiped him. Then Jesus said to them, "Do not be afraid. Go and tell my brothers to go to Galilee, and there they will see me." This is the gospel of our Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
We sing our processional hymn.
Our triumph.
Alleluia, Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed.
Alleluia.
Welcome, everyone, as we celebrate together the resurrection of our Lord. Welcome to our guests. Welcome those worshiping online. We just rejoice that we could be gathered here together and celebrate this good news.
Death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is your victory?
O death, where is your sting?
The sting of death is sin, and the power of sin is the law.
But thanks be to God. He gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ.
Therefore, my beloved brothers and sisters, let us confess our sins unto God our Father.
I confess to you, most merciful God, that I have sinned against you in my thoughts, words, and deeds, those that I have done, as well as the good I have failed to do. It is my own sin that condemns me. In your mercy and according to your promise, forgive me my sin. Create a new heart in me. Restore to me the joy of your salvation for the sake of Jesus Christ, my Lord and my God. Amen.
Upon this, your confession, I, by virtue of my office as a called and ordained servant of the word, announce the grace of God to you, and in the stead and by the command of our risen Lord Jesus Christ, I forgive you all your sins in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please be seated.
Please join in the responsive reading of the introit. I will sing to the Lord, for he has triumphed gloriously. The horse and his rider he has thrown into the sea. Your right hand, O Lord, glorious in power. Your right hand, O Lord, shatters the enemy.
You have led in your steadfast love the people whom you have redeemed. You have guided them by your strength to your holy abode.
You will bring them in and plant them on your own mountain, the place, O Lord, which you have made for your abode, the sanctuary, O Lord, which your hands have established. The Lord will reign forever and ever.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
I will sing to the Lord, for he has triumphed gloriously. The horse and his rider he has thrown into the sea.
This is the feast of victory for our God.
Almighty God the Father, through your only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, you have overcome death and opened the gate of everlasting life to us. Grant that we who celebrate with joy the day of our Lord's resurrection may be raised from the death of sin by your life-giving Spirit. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Our first reading is from Acts chapter 10, beginning at the 34th verse. Peter opened his mouth and said, "Truly I understand that God shows no partiality, but in every nation anyone who fears him and does what is right is acceptable to him. As for the word that he sent to Israel, preaching good news of peace through Jesus Christ, he is Lord of all. You yourselves know what happened throughout all Judea, beginning with Galilee after the baptism that John proclaimed. How God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and with power. He went about doing good and healing all who were oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. And we are witnesses of all that he did, both in the country of the Jews and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree. But God raised him on the third day and made him appear, not to all people, but to us who had been chosen by God as witnesses, who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. And he commanded us to preach to the people and to testify that he is the one appointed by God to be judge of the living and the dead. To him all the prophets bear witness that everyone who believes in him receives forgiveness of sins through his name. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our epistle is from Colossians chapter 3, beginning at the first verse. If then you have been raised with Christ, seek the things that are above, where Christ is, seated at the right hand of God. Set your minds on things that are above, not on things that are on earth. For you have died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God. When Christ, who is your life, appears, then you also will appear with him in glory. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We will now hear from the bell choir.
Thank you, Bell Choir. Invite the children to join me now for the children's message. Hi, Rainer. Give me five. Hi, girls. Happy Easter. How's everyone doing today? Do you remember last week when you were here, I gave you a little cross? Remember Palm Sunday, we were waving palms and things? Oh, yeah. You got a blue one? Okay. So this one reminded us that Jesus died on the cross. And then after Jesus died on the cross, they took his body off the cross, and then they put it in a cave, and they rolled a stone over the front of the cave. So Jesus was dead in the cave, okay? Last week, you also, during Sunday school time, you had an Easter egg hunt, right? And you found some eggs? And what if you had an egg hunt and you didn't find any eggs? That wouldn't be real fun, would it? Did you find some? But if you didn't find any, you'd probably be pretty sad, right? Well, the people that watched Jesus die on the cross, they were sad. And there were some ladies, including Jesus' mother was there, and she was sad. And some ladies watched them put Jesus' body in this tomb in the cave. And then they went back a couple of days later, and they were expecting to find Jesus' body there. But they didn't find him there. Instead, they saw an angel, and an angel said, "Jesus isn't here anymore. He's alive." Pretty amazing, isn't it? Jesus is alive and well, and Jesus continues to love you and to take care of you and to help you and always be with you. Because you are special to him, Rainer. You are special to him, Hannah. You are special to him, Scarlett. Candace, you are special to him as well. So I have something to remind you that you are special to Jesus. This one says, "Jesus loves me." Jesus loves me. Jesus loves me. And this one says, "Jesus loves me," for Rainer. Oh, good. Well, let's say a prayer. Dear Jesus, we thank you that you are alive and that you love these children of yours. Continue to bless them and remind them how special they are to you. And help us, Jesus, to remember how special you are to us. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Thank you, guys. Oh, good, good. You're welcome. We'll now hear from the choir.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, choir. And thank you, choir, for serving this choir season. This is your last time that you're serving for this choir season. Some of you are heading back home, but thank you for your service. Let's thank them again, please. So some of the children had an egg hunt during Sunday school last week. How many went on an egg hunt today? How many of you ate breakfast today? Scrambled eggs, right? So you did an egg hunt, you just didn't know it. So now thank you for the men that made the breakfast and all who served and cleaned up and things like that. Please stand now as we speak together the words of the Alleluia verse. Alleluia. Christ Jesus abolished death and brought life and immortality to light through the gospel. Alleluia. As believers, as brothers and sisters in Christ, we confess our faith together with the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Please be seated as we sing. Hallelujah, Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed. Hallelujah.
Please be seated. Have you heard the saying that with God all things are possible? You know where that comes from? It's from the Bible, and Jesus is the one who says it. Now, Jesus was talking about something different with his followers. They were, in fact, talking about, Jesus had just said, it's easier for a camel to go through the eye of a needle than for a rich person to enter the kingdom of God. The disciples say, well, who then can be saved? And Jesus says, with man, this is impossible, But with God, all things are possible. We worship and serve this God of all things possible. I've been preaching on the book of Genesis, and we talked about God creating everything out of nothing, just by speaking the word. Seems impossible that this could happen, the creation. But we worship and serve this God of all things possible. We talked about Adam and Eve and their sin in the garden. And as we continue to read through the book of Genesis and throughout the whole Bible, in fact, we see that we too are sinners. And that on our own, we would be in big trouble. We would be condemned. But on Good Friday, God changed all that. Jesus changed all that because what we couldn't do on our own, Jesus did for us. He took the punishment for your sins and for my sins in order to save us. On our own, our salvation is impossible. But with Jesus, we rejoice in his grace and mercy. We rejoice in the Savior of all things possible. As we page through our Bibles, it's just filled with seemingly impossible stuff. Abraham and Sarah, they're too old to have a child, and yet God blesses them with Isaac in their old age. Roman soldiers guard the tomb of a dead man, and tough soldiers, they act like dead men when an angel comes and rolls the stone away. Early on Easter morning, some women come to the tomb expecting to find a dead Jesus. And they hear the seemingly impossible news from this angel. He is not here, for he has risen. There is death from life. There is forgiveness and love. There is victory over sin, over death, and over the grave. We serve and worship a risen Savior of all things possible. Before Julie and I drove here from Pennsylvania, a dear friend of us gave us a gift that we have on our windowsill in our kitchen. It's up on the screen. It says, "Expect miracles. The Lord your God will be with you." Do you expect miracles? I could keep on going on and on with miracles from the Bible. You know, back in Egypt, God sent 10 plagues for Pharaoh to release his people. Eventually, he does. And then God's people, they're freed, and then they're stuck. They're trapped at the Red Sea. They're afraid. They don't know how this is going to work out for them. They wish they were back in Egypt, but God does the miracle, the seemingly impossible. He parts the Red Sea, and the people pass through on dry ground. Miraculous stuff. Do we live, though, like we serve this God of all things possible? There's a prayer that's attributed to the English explorer Sir Francis Drake. He's probably best known for sailing around the world in a single expedition from 1577 to 1580. So this is, you know, a few years after Martin Luther. And just imagine, though, like sailing a ship back then at that time, late 1500s, how difficult that must have been. But listen now to Sir Francis Drake's prayer. "Disturb us, Lord, when we are too well pleased with ourselves, when our dreams have come true because we have dreamed too little, when we arrive safely because we sailed too close to the shore. Disturb us, Lord, when with the abundance of the things we possess, we have lost our thirst for the waters of life. Having fallen in love with life, we have ceased to dream of eternity. And in our efforts to build a new earth, we have allowed our vision of the new heaven to dim. Disturb us, Lord, to dare more boldly, to venture on wider seas, where storms will show your mastery. Where losing sight of land, we shall find the stars. We ask you to push back the horizons of our hopes and to push into the future in strength, courage, hope, and love. Do we dream big or do we dream too little? Do we play it safe? Do we live like we have a risen and living Savior? The angel told those women, "He is not here, for he has risen." And do we live that way, though? Do we live knowing that the God of all things possible is alive and well and with us every moment of every day? Do we pray big? Sometimes people tell me, well, others have it worse than me, or God has a lot of other people to worry about. Well, we serve and worship a big God who's there to hear all of your prayers for big stuff, for smaller stuff, and for everything in between. The risen and living Jesus, the one who knows every hair on your head, directs you to call upon him because he's there for every moment of your life, every day, no matter what you may be going through. Our God of all things possible is bigger than any problem that you may have. All things are possible through him. Do we dream too little as his church, as to what Jesus may want to accomplish through us? Do we confine ourselves to thinking of what we can accomplish on our own? Or do we trust in this God of all things possible and what he can accomplish through us? He's assembled us here. He's gathered us together from many, many different places to be his church here in Lake Havasu at this time and at this place. And he's given us different gifts to serve. And he calls us to use those collective gifts together to proclaim his greatness. Sometimes we refuse to dream big or to dream boldly. Maybe we're afraid to take that step in faith. Maybe we lack confidence. Maybe we're just afraid to fail. On the cross, it looked like Jesus had failed. He hadn't even met the expectations of his own followers. He hadn't liberated them from the bad Roman government that was ruling over them and oppressing them. When Jesus said on the cross, "It is finished," and he bowed his head and breathed his last, it looked like Jesus had failed. The devil on Good Friday was probably doing his happy dance as Jesus lay there dead on the cross. Jesus, his friends, and his mother, they were mourning at the cross. They stood by helpless. All their hopes and dreams were seemingly gone. But that all changed. That's what today is all about. Jesus' big plan didn't end when he breathed his last on that cross. Jesus' big plan included Easter Sunday. And Jesus has big plans for you as well. Because his resurrection means your resurrection. His death means your life. His big plan includes spending eternity with you. The God of all things possible can do way more than we could ever dream of. The Apostle Paul writes this in his letter to Jesus' church in Ephesus. "Now to him who is able to do immeasurably more than all we ask or imagine, according to his power that is at work within us, to him be glory in the church and in Christ Jesus throughout all generations, forever and ever." This God who can do immeasurably more than we could ever ask or imagine, this God of all things possible, is able to fix broken relationships. He's able to fix financial struggles. He's able to fix people like us who've been broken by sin. Do you know what? Jesus' dream, Jesus' big plan is for us to share this good news with others. We don't worship a dead Savior who's still lying there in the tomb. We don't just worship some good teacher or some guy who was a good example for us to imitate. We worship Jesus, the crucified, the once dead but now living Savior, the Son of God who came into this world, this Savior who has good plans. And his plan was to save you and me and many more from all of our many sins. Those women who went to the tomb that morning, they expected to find a dead Jesus. They had brought along some spices. Their plan was to give Jesus what we would call a proper burial. Imagine their surprise, though, when they get to the tomb. There's this earthquake, and then this angel rolls back the stone. And we're told that the angel's appearance was like lightning, and his clothing is white like snow. You remember snow, don't you? But these guards, these tough guys, they play dead at the sight of this angel. And if that's not impossible enough, as we heard, this angel has more good news. Jesus isn't here, the angel says. He's risen. Then go quickly and tell his disciples that he has risen from the dead, and behold, he is going before you to Galilee. There you will see him. Anyone know what will happen in Galilee? Well, just 5 verses after our gospel reading ends for today, we're told that the 11 apostles, minus Judas, they go to Galilee, and Jesus tells them the big plans that he has for them and for us. Let's read this together. All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go, therefore, and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all that I have commanded you. And behold, I am with you always to the end of the age. So Jesus, he rises from the dead, he goes to Galilee, and there he shares his big plans to grow his church. And he sends them off to share this big news. Jesus was dreaming big. The women hear this good news from the angel, and we're told that they depart quickly with fear and great joy. And they run to tell his disciples. And behold, Jesus meets them and says, "Greetings." And they come up and take hold of his feet and they worship him. Then Jesus says to them, "Don't be afraid. Go and tell my brothers to go to Galilee, and there they will see me." Do you think that these women might have been changed by this experience, this awesome miracle, this awesome experience? They had seen the risen Jesus. And so they bow down at his feet and they worship him. They were changed. They were now different. They had this encounter with the risen and living Jesus, and they have this good news to share, first with the brothers, the disciples, and then with everyone else. To go back to this prayer by Sir Francis Drake, "Disturb us, Lord, when we are too well pleased with ourselves, when our dreams have come true because we have dreamed too little, when we arrive safely because we sailed too close to the shore." Are we taking risks for Jesus? We, like those women, we've had an encounter too with the risen and living Jesus. But are we dreaming too little? Are we playing it safe by keeping too close to the shore? Are we content to play in the shallow water rather than taking the plunge in the much deeper waters. The God of all things possible is able to reach the lost and empowers us. He's the one who leaves the 99 in order to find the one. He's able to draw people to himself through his miraculous word that goes forth, even people who we may think are impossible for us to reach for Jesus. And Jesus uses us as part of his big plan to share his good news so that more and more may worship him, both now and for eternity. We're called to dream big. Let's read together this verse from Psalm 40 that's on the screen. You have multiplied, O Lord my God, your wondrous deeds and your thoughts toward us. None can compare with you. I will proclaim and tell of them, yet they are more than can be told. I will proclaim and tell of them of God's wondrous deeds for us, more than can be told, more than we could ever have imagined, more than we deserve. Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, we're blessed that we have a risen and living Savior who loves us and promises to be with us, and he uses us collectively to grow his church. With him, all things are possible. As his church, as his people, we look forward to the day of a new heaven and a new earth that Jesus' resurrection has inaugurated, that's brought about to all who believe. A day when the seemingly impossible will occur. A time when he will wipe away every tear from our eyes. And there will be no more suffering or mourning or crying or pain anymore, for the former things have passed away. Jesus, you are so good to us. Let us pray. Disturb us, Lord, so that we dream big for you. Guide us to step outside of our comfort zone, to take risks, to make a big difference, an eternal difference, in the lives of people who are perishing as we share your good news. Good news of a once dead and now living Savior. Good news of forgiveness and salvation. Good news of love and grace and mercy. Good news of life, eternal life. Good news of a God of all things possible. Steer your church, Jesus, into deep waters and use us to be fishers of men for you. Alleluia, Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed.
Alleluia. We continue now with our offering.
Risen Lord, you provide for us in great bounty. And Lord, we ask your blessing upon these offerings, that they may serve effectively in your earthly ministry. Amen. Please rise for the offertory. Almighty and ever-living God, Hear our prayer of thanksgiving for your gift of new, eternal life in the forgiveness of our sins by faith in our risen and living Savior, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Help us to live in the certainty and awareness of his resurrection from the dead and the promise of ours in the life of the world to come. Lord, in your mercy. For your whole church throughout the world and for our congregation, inspire in us the spirit of truth, unity, and concord. Grant that all who confess your holy name to agree in truth of your holy word and to live in unity and godly love. Lord, in your mercy. Heavenly Father, save and defend our country. Grant to all in authority wisdom and strength to know and do your will. Direct the hearts of all rulers throughout the world that they may minister justice and strive for peace. Lord, in your mercy. By your goodness, O Lord, mercifully consider all assembled here in your name to celebrate and the remembrance of the most glorious death and resurrection of your Son. Comfort and help all those who are in trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, and any adversity, and all who request our prayers. Lord, be with them for that healing and restoration. By your grace, grant them your healing and strength, and defend them from every evil to body and soul. Lord, in your mercy. We commend to your mercy, O Lord, all of your servants who remain steadfast in their faith and whom you have called to their heavenly home. Thank you, Jesus, for your victory over death and the grave. Give us strength as we live our lives for you, as we await the blessed family reunion celebration in your heavenly kingdom. Lord, in your mercy. Grant this, O Father, for the sake of Jesus Christ, our only mediator and advocate, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. You may be seated. We will hear from the guitar group.
Thank you, guitar group. Please stand as we pray together the prayer that our risen Jesus has taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. We're reminded again with Jesus' big plan for us, his church. Jesus said, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go, therefore, and make disciples of all nations." Lord, help us to see the challenges and responsibilities to reach the lost all around us. Jesus said, "Go and baptize the nations in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit." Use us, Lord, to extend your kingdom and to be your witnesses. Jesus said, "Go and teach the nations all that I have commanded you." Jesus said, "I am with you always to the end of the age." The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. Amen. Please be seated as we sing.
Thank you.
Alleluia, Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed. Alleluia.
Well, we thank you all for worshiping with us, our risen Lord, today. If this is your first time here, and if you've not received the mug yet, please see one of the ushers in the back when you leave. We have a gift for you to take back. And if you're looking for a church home, please consider here. We worship Saturday nights at 5:30, Sunday mornings at 9 o'clock. Thanks for worshiping with us. Have a blessed Easter.
We pray our message of hope from our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ lifts you up and strengthens you for the coming week. Have a blessed week. For information about us, please visit our website at lamofgodlhcaz.org. That's lamofgodlhcaz.org.